Hi, my name is Timothy Jordan. I'm a developer advocate here at Google, and I'd like to give you a quick introduction to Android Wear. Now, Android Wear is a set of APIs that extends the Android platform to a new generation of wearables. Rich notifications can appear on the wearable with no modification to the existing Android app. And the developer can add just a few more lines of code to extend the wearable experience or go even deeper by building an app just for the wearable. Now, before we dive into the details of the platform, let's take a step back. What's wrong with this picture? We spent some time looking at technology usage and thought deeply about the ways to help you stay more connected to the digital world, but also more engaged with what's happening around you. Android Wear looks to address this by showing you useful information the moment you need it and just in a glance. Now let's look at that in a more technical way. This is your day with your phone. Notice the length of time it takes to pull out your phone from your pocket, unlock it, navigate to what you want, and then engage with it. Well, there's a hefty time and attention cost, even for interactions that should only require a moment. This is the same set of interactions on a wearable. Notice the reduced overhead per interaction. Now, this is what we mean by more present in the real world and yet more connected to the virtual world. What does this mean for your development? Well, to start with, and this is important, it's a fundamentally different user interaction model. And you can tell just by looking at this device. It's a fundamentally different device from other mobile devices. To really nail the user experience, you gotta rethink it a little. When considering which features of your service you'd like to make available on the wrist, consider this question. What couldn't we do on the phone that we can now do on the wrist? What now becomes possible with the user? And then focus on that. Also, you gotta try it. It may sound silly, but once you get that emulator up and running, stand up at your desk and pretend you're walking between meetings or across the street, something to get yourself in the situation so you know what it feels like to use the service on the go. Here's an example of what we mean by a very basic but essential difference. This is the app experience on your phone. Now, we've trained users to collect these shiny objects and then search for them when they want to do something, which works okay on a phone. But if we put these same shiny objects on a wearable, well, it just doesn't make sense. It'd be the same time-consuming paradigm, but on a device intended to reduce those parts of the interaction. It just doesn't make sense. How do we get outside of this paradigm? How do we get past this grid of icons? This is the Android Wear interface. It's simple, glanceable, and built around micro-interactions. The interface is divided into two primary behaviors. The user can talk to the wearable. You can think of these as actions. The user might say, OK, Google, and then any voice command is available to them. The wearable can talk to the user. Now think of this as a context stream. It's sort of like enhanced notifications that matter to the user right now because it's the right time or place. Okay, let's talk about developing with Android Wear. First, notifications. The notifications on your phone can also be displayed on the wearable. And to get this done, you don't have to do anything. It just works out of the box. Also, notifications that buzz or sound on the companion device, such as your phone, will also buzz on the wearable. Enhanced notifications will also show up on the wearable. And again, to get this done, you still don't have to do anything. It also already works out of the box. Now, there are a few things that you can do with your notifications specifically on the wearable, and these do require a few lines of code. Stacks allow you to bundle multiple notifications together. Think inbox-style notifications. Pages, they give you the ability to show more than one glanceable screen of information to the user for a single notification. And yes, pages can be combined with stacks. Replies. They allow you to add actions to notifications that the user can control with their voice via open-ended text input or through predefined text responses. Now, if you want to have code running on the wearable, you're going to have to build an app. The SDK for apps isn't available yet, but here's a few notes to get you started thinking about them. You can create custom card layouts and run activities directly on wearables. You can send data and actions between the phone and a wearable with data replication APIs and remote procedure calls. You can gather sensor data and display it in real time on Android wearables. And you can register your app to handle voice actions like, OK Google, take a note. And that's the Android Wear platform. Please check out the more detail on our excellent documentation, developer.android.com/wear. I'm Timothy Jordan, and I'll see you next time.